Hi, this is Jim Elgendorf. My wife Elizabeth and I are continuing our journey of traveling together to a new America. Elizabeth passed away about a year and a half ago, but we're together still, heart to heart, in life, in death, moving together, reaching out to people all across this country. You know, amid all of the chaos and division and pandemics and wars and politics, there's a new world really struggling for expression, struggling and crying to come into being. I'd like to read just a short piece to you today. This is called The Secret Door. To live 80 or 90 years, to have been rich, to have found love, to have traveled to the ends of the earth, to have been the president of a big company, to have been a professor of this or that, to have played golf whenever you wished in your retirement, to have been a great sports hero, to have been a beautiful woman, to have eaten delicious food every day of your life, to have won the lottery, to have invented a better computer, to have been a philanthropist, to have taken vacations whenever and wherever you wished, to have been lucky in your health, to have lived in the most beautiful places, to have owned a beautiful home, any of these and infinitely more desires fulfilled and goals won were nothing at the end of the day, at the end of your allotted time, if you had not found the secret door, the way into another dimension, as you stood with your feet on the ground and the spring air soft about your head and the rain and thunder and lightning and rainbows and people everywhere, and failed to notice that where you stood and who you were was eternity. I'd like to just finally say, amid these times, especially to the young people of this country, please keep faith with yourself. Keep faith with your greatest dreams, not only for yourself, but for other people and for our country and for the world. Nam myoho renge kyo.